Hey guys, how's it going? This is David Kwan here. I hope you guys had a wonderful and amazing Thanksgiving for those of you guys who celebrated. For those of you who celebrated in a deliberate different manner or commemorated in different manner, I hope you guys had a great chance to respect and honor the National Day of Mourning. For those who don't celebrate it for whatever reason, because maybe you're not American or you celebrate it in your culture's way or whatever, well, I hope you had a good, maybe hope you had a good time off, because a lot of people do get some time off in this time, or get together with their family or whatever, or just, you know, some time off. I hope you guys got that. If not, because I do realize a lot of people also have to work. Well, you know, anyway, just happy holidays for those people, I guess, because, yeah. So, all that political correctness out of the way. This year for me, as is usual for every year for me, to me, it is Thanksgiving. I do celebrate Thanksgiving in that kind of manner. I try not to associate with the actual history of it, but people don't really talk about that. In my experience, it's just time to. It's a good excuse to get together and eat a lot of food, drink a lot, talk a lot, and yeah, just time to enjoy yourselves. And I've talked about in like other video where it seems like my Thanksgiving, I usually just crash on other people's Thanksgiving, it seems like. I don't know how that always happens, but it definitely happened this year for me too. Last year, it happened, I crashed on my boss's Thanksgiving. So my boss and her boyfriend were having this Thanksgiving, and she invited a bunch of us and coworkers. So we got together. And her boyfriend's vegan, and I'm vegan, so that was a really great Thanksgiving, because I can eat everything without having to, I guess, compromise my values or anything like that. This Thanksgiving that I went to, so my friend's friend lives in New Jersey, and we were invited. She had her mom come over, and they had, like, really great Southern Thanksgiving feast. But, of course, it's Southern Thanksgiving feast, so totally not vegan. Some of the stuff, not even vegetarian. So, in that setting, I did have to be like, you know, okay, I might have to be vegetarian today. But it's still like, still vegetarian, you know. I'm not going to eat turkey. They had turkey. They had this corn dish. Not really sure the names of the dishes. You know, they had the green pea dish, cranberry sauce, and stuffing. I couldn't eat the stuffing because they use like chicken stock. I think I mentioned this before, but that's the toughest thing about like being a vegan or even a vegetarian, you know, when we were in this, vegan is definitely harder, just because it's such a minority position, especially on Thanksgiving where the, focus is so much on like, you know, the turkey and whatnot, or some kind of meat for different kind of cultures. So, yeah, but it was really nice. We had a good time. Got to eat a lot, talk a lot, drank a lot of wine. So that, and wine always kind of makes me like feel cozy and sleepy. So afterwards, I went over to my friend's apartment in the city, and I just crashed. I passed out like I've never had before. I woke up like, whoa, okay, I was out. I was really out. So that was Thanksgiving Day. Friday was really good too, cause I got to meet another friend of mine, and she actually wanted to hang out on Thanksgiving Day, but she's a nurse, so she had to work Thanksgiving. She was like, "If I'm not working, would you want to hang out?" But she ended up working. We met up and we just ordered out. I had a falafel sandwich. She had something like chicken and rice or something. So it was cool, good time to just eat and talk with each other. We had quite some serious discussions there, though. Like, I haven't seen her in a while, so maybe that's, like, why, like, we had, like, very, like, some political discussions as well. But, like, I think I enjoy it. I don't know how much she enjoys it. I don't know. But at one point, we even got to, like, because she's a nurse, so and I'm a social work student, so some of our interests overlap, so there's definitely a lot to discuss there. And it was cool. And we also went to Best Buy together because I think I saw online, I was like, whoa, there's this computer touchscreen laptop that they're selling for $250. Like, I want to check that out. So I kind of like nerded out all over that in Best Buy, whatever. It wasn't really that bad. Black Friday, like, well, we went at a later time, but it wasn't as like crowded and crazy and as I expected it to be. So that was cool. And then I finished the Friday night with, I hung out again with a friend. We went to a bar and first we went to this Flatiron Room place. It's very kind of more refined place, and they do whiskey and dinner. Never really had that like kind of whiskey before, so that was interesting. It's like it's very refined drink, and I only had one dram of, what was it called? I don't even know what it was called, but it's like, man, those are strong whiskey. They're like 50 or 60% alcohol. It's like, boom. It's amazing. Especially because how cold it is now in New York City. Or it got cold all of a sudden, it feels. That was nice. And then my friend and I, we went to the bar that we haven't gone to in a long time. And got pretty drunk. And it was nice. So that was my Thanksgiving. It was really great. Like, I haven't had... I feel so glad that like this happened. This Thanksgiving break, like I have a couple of days off. I got to just waste two of my days just having fun and just enjoying company of my friends. And I still have today and tomorrow and Monday to catch up on like school stuff and my internship stuff. So it was so needed because before like I was just focused on internship and school and I was like feeling really overwhelmed and I was like. Just barely making it. But you know, this was really, really helpful, and I'm feeling more optimistic about this college semester because I was feeling really down after getting a really bad grade on one of my midterms. But that teacher actually gave an offer. Like, it's a weird thing though. I have mixed feelings about this, but she said if you want, you know, if your midterm grade is something that like you're totally not satisfied with, you can choose to have it be less impactful for your overall grade of the, and your final paper will be weighted more heavily. So I chose to do that. So my midterm paper is going to be like 12.5% of the grade, and my final is going to be like 40-something percent of the grade. So I better do damn well on my final. So that's the gamble here, because my midterm was so bad. But yeah. My other midterm that I were like, I don't know, I just kind of typed it up, whatever. I got an A minus on that for some reason, so that's amazing. I feel pretty confident about my most other classes. I just have to get to working on all my finals. I have 4 final papers to write, so got to get working on that. I have to get that done by like first week of December, so got to get working on that, right? But I have time. This Thanksgiving break was definitely a great time for that, and yeah, it was a good holiday for me, and I wonder like which Thanksgiving I'm gonna crash on next year. Like, whose Thanksgiving am I gonna crash next year? I have no idea, but it's like that's how it always happens with me for some whatever reason. But anyway, how was your guys' holidays? If you guys want to share how your Thanksgiving or National Year Morning or your other holiday was like. You know, feel free to comment, whatever. So, yeah, hope you have a good one. Cheers.